Bob Thompson.
And I'm Bob North.
And this is Weekday Update.
And here are today's top stories.
With drug trafficking on the rise, the U.S. government is having a difficult time expelling drugs like marijuana from the country, whereas head of the U.S. government, President George Bush, is still having a hard time spelling marijuana.
Truly a day, a paleontologist at the University of Cambridge, England, told the Associated Press that footprints preserved in English mud indicate that dinosaurs of various species may have herded together. British scientists discovered the tracks of 40 different plant-eating dinosaurs traveled in large groups. So basically, all of our tax dollars have just led to the discovery that dinosaurs weren't racist.
Dave Schrader, an engineer with Teradata, a division of automatic teller machine manufacturer NCR, is attempting to give consumers a better banking experience by teaching ATMs to discern emotions. These mood-detecting ATMs will read certain physical features in your face, like a frown or a lowered eyebrow, to determine the user's mood. Early estimates project that the multi-million dollar installation of these emotion-sensing ATMs will be the biggest waste of money since the XFL.
Voicestream Wireless has put up a cell phone tower disguised as an 85-foot-tall white cross in Westminster, Maryland. The cross replaces a much shorter wooden one at Lighthouse Worship Center. Apparently, Voicestream didn't think turning the Holy Crucifix into a cell phone tower would offend anyone.
Reverend Jesse Jackson has accepted an invitation to visit the Middle East, and will be making the trip sometime between June 8th and June 14th, according to Palestinian Authority spokesman Hassan Abdel Rahman. Jackson wishes to meet with the families that have been affected by the Palestinian bombing attacks. Meanwhile, people in the United States are wishing that Jackson becomes a Palestinian bombing attack.
Dr. Rayan Al-Gahayan and others from the Department of Surgery at King's College Hospital recently conducted a series of tests. Their new research concluded that surgeons who stay out late drinking suffer a noticeable decline in surgical performance the next morning. Even newer research shows that scientists are running out of things to research.
Pennsylvania National Guard troops have been patrolling the state's 5 nuclear power plants with unloaded weapons, according to a state lawmaker. The guardsmen had been banned from carrying loaded weapons while on patrol at Pennsylvania airports following the September 11 terrorist attacks. Apparently, the guards plan to stop the terrorists with harsh language.
IBM has signed what it hopes to be their biggest supercomputer deal ever, a contract for up to $224 million to improve their National Weather Service forecasting technology. By July 2003, the system will completely take over the task of predicting weather throughout the country. This new supercomputer will be able to inaccurately predict the weather 10 times faster than normal.
In a bizarre story yesterday, Gil St. Jean discovered a snake living inside his computer. When he tried to eject the CD, the snake's head popped up instead. Gil then took the computer outside, opening it up, allowing for the snake to escape. You see, this is what happens when you don't upgrade your virus protection.
And now let's go out to Bob Trent live in the field, who's doing a report on the bunkers in Nahant, Massachusetts.
Thanks, Bob. I'm Bob Trent, here on location on Bailey's Hill in Nahant, Massachusetts. As you can see behind me, there are World War II bunkers that were created to protect Nahant, Massachusetts from an attack that never...
The Department of Foreign Affairs and Trade has warned Australians to avoid such areas as Jammu and Kashmir in India, stating, in light of the heightened tensions between India and Pakistan, Australians and India should exercise extreme caution and maintain a high level of personal security awareness. Well, gee, thanks for the heads up, Captain Obvious.
Movie theater owners across the country are angry with their patrons who smuggle in their own food and drink to the theaters, as opposed to buying the theater's overpriced concessions. The owners don't seem to understand why people wouldn't want to pay $8 for a bottle of water.
In another very bizarre story, Transformer toys have been placed on the U.S.'s Department of Transportation's banned list. The listing states that certain Transformer toys transform into something that looks like a gun. Well, it's a good thing that Decepticons can fly themselves. However, Autobots will have to drive or take the bus.
Now let's check back with Bob Trent in the field and see how he's doing. That's all for this edition of Weekday Update.
I'm Bob North.
And I'm Bob Thompson.
That's my story, and I'm sticking to it.